to tonight to our first case this evening, which happens to be a City of Valdosta case. Matt, let's go ahead and look at CU 2018-13 Centella Charter Academy, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. This is a conditional use permit request by Centella Charter Academy. Some of you may recall a similar request 4 years ago by the same applicant for approval of a charter school that was the elementary school in R10 property. Property is located at 2171 East Park Avenue. This is to the north of the J.L. Newbern Middle School, and just south of the Lonesome Dove Road intersection, and not too far from the back entrance of the new Valdosta High School. In your packet is a copy of the land use certificate as well as the original master plan for 2014. The main feature there is to put a cap of 65,000 square feet of building area on the size of the facility. And the applicant is now wishing to go beyond that amount and include a middle school campus and some minor reworking of their site plan. The aerial imagery shows the existing school inside the subject property. There's plenty of room there to expand, as you see to the west. There's also the J.L. Newbern School that you see the rooftops there at the bottom of the screen. And of course, a larger version of this is in your packet. This is the site plan or master plan from 2014. They've actually added one more building, staying below the 65,000 square foot cap. The site plan, as approved back in 2014, looks like this. A larger copy of that is in your packet. And then the proposed master plan, as the big picture, looks like this. In the work session, we talked about this at length, but in the PowerPoint, I've gone ahead and zoomed in from east to west. You can see the print a little better. See the existing buildings that are there in orange, the existing parking lot that would expand. They're going to reverse the flow of the driveway stacking for their traffic. So rather than stacking from the west and working to the east in front of the school for pickup, we'll now start stacking from the east side in the main parking lot and work its way westward. The middle portion shows the new buildings in red. See the pickup area in between them, that is for both the elementary and the middle school. And then the west side of the campus will be where the athletic fields will be relocated to. They're requesting approval for doubling of the size of square footage from 65,000 to 130,000. Although this master plan that you see is not quite that much, it's a little over 100,000, so that 130 will give them additional room to expand without having to come back to the public hearing process. So basically double of what they have. Parking, as staff has observed, even as of this afternoon, there is no issue there. They're going to be required to do a traffic impact statement with their engineer to be reviewed by the city engineer. There was an email this afternoon from their civil engineer that stated that they are waiting on some updated traffic information from the city. The official counts do not include the Valdosta High School traffic, so they're trying to get that additional background information so they can plug it into their computer model. The applicants are here. If you have some detailed questions, the staff is just like we did 4 years ago. Finding this consistent with the comprehensive plan, the conditional use review criteria, which are there in the packet, and we're recommending approval with a few conditions. There are three. They are in your packet, but I will go ahead and read them for the record. Number one, conditional use approval shall be granted for both an elementary school and middle school shared campus grades pre-K through 8, including school recreational facilities, based on the general layout of the revised master plan, with a total building area not to exceed 130,000 square feet. Site design shall comply with all applicable LDR standards for said schools. Outdoor activities shall be limited to daytime and early evening hours, not exceeding 9 p.m. All on-site lighting shall be directed away from the northern property line. Number two, a minimum 50-foot wide landscape buffer shall be extended and remain as undisturbed along the entire northern property line. Additional native trees and shrubs shall be planted to fill in the bare patches of this buffer area as approved by the city arborist in accordance with the site's approved landscape plan. And then lastly, conditional use approval shall supersede the approval from 2014 and shall expire after 3 years from the date of this approval if the middle school portion of the campus provisions for those that were granted in 2014, you'll see a lot of similarity. And the gist of it is carrying the same conditions forward, but increasing the cap from 65 to 130. Glad to answer any questions you may have.
I just have a few questions, ma'am. You touched on several of them. I know we're going to increase the footprint, which is going to mean we're going to increase teacher activity, children activity, road traffic activity. And you mentioned that they were going to do a study. My question is that not what you said?
Correct.
Okay. My question is, with the new Valdosta High School right down the street, did they do a study?
They are exempt from it because it is governmental development property. This
That's
is
what
not.
I said.
There are three schools in this area, and this one has to fly by some different rules than the other two. That being said, remember from 4 years ago, there was a reservation / dedication of an 80-foot right-of-way, which is the extension of the North Side Drive. That right-of-way is in place, but the road has not yet been extended. I emphasize the word yet. And I think one of the purposes of the study is to determine if the need for the extension of that road is upon us with this expansion, or if we are simply getting close. It's staff's current guess that we are simply getting close. But it's also this staff's recommendation that we go ahead and do it if we can. But that would be part of the features of the study.
So my next question, maybe the exact same answer that I want to ask you, is in one of your conditions, you set a time period that all eligible activities
That's a carryover from 2014.
So I'm just curious now. Is that exactly the Valdosta High School exempt from that in their same place? Or?
Valdosta High School and J.L. Newburn do not have that same requirement. If you look at, not that we would be able to impose that, but the surroundings are a little bit different. J.L. Newburn has no residential neighborhood next to it, nor does the high school, but this one does. And I think, and just like they show in the master plan, they show compliance. It's a 50-foot buffer. They've oriented their fields away from the neighborhood, like good neighbors should. I don't anticipate any problem, but the condition's there to help make sure of.
Mr. Chairman, if I can piggyback on that, I also have read that question about that 9 p.m., the evening hours. We're now moving into middle school, which are older children, and the activities usually run later in the evenings. And I see that there's a baseball field there. So sometimes these baseball games run late into the evening. Are they okay? Is the school okay with this 9 p.m. curfew? Or is that something that's been in contention?
It has not been in contention, but the applicant can address that better than I can.
Okay.
It was discussed in the initial meetings. We simply carried forward the conditions for 4 years.
Wishing to speak in favor of this request to come forward this time. Anyone wishing to speak in favor of this request? How you doing this evening?
Good, how are you?
Good. Just a name and address for the record, sir.
Zachary Tower, my home address.
Office would be fine.
109 West of Air Street, Austin. And then Andy Gabriel's with me. I'm Zachary Coward. I'm the board chair at Centilla. We're in our fourth year of operation. We appreciate y'all taking this under advisement and approving it, I guess, 4 years ago to allow us to get going. The school's been able to acquire, actually, this total parcel that y'all see up there. We're initially operating with a developer under 15 acres, but we're able to buy the school and expand to the full acreage. There's a big demand within the school for parents to have their kids go up from 5th, 6th, 7th, and 8th, and, you know, get the consistency all the way through. So This is kind of our first step in that process. In the event that it's recommended and approved, that will allow us at least to move forward. We have to go to the state level and get approval from the state to authorize us to go up those additional grades. But this is something that we feel like needs to be in place before we do that. That's something that we intend to ask for probably in the beginning of next year, and hopefully have an answer by March or April. So that's kind of the next step before we can move forward. The financing is in place to be able to build out, as y'all see, but it's the limitation simply is just when the state says you can go forward.
To answer your question, Ms. Roundtree, yes, we'd be happy to be in compliance with the 9 o'clock curfew. We will add grades 6 through 8 one at a time. We're small schools still in such a situation where we have tons of teams playing multiple and things would run over, so that wouldn't be a problem.
So is the baseball field going to be a lit field?
We haven't even gotten that far yet.
Okay.
All these are just...
I mean, the intent would be for it to be at some point.
Yeah.
Just depending on cost initially with the financing that's in place. But yeah, I mean, don't recommend it be later.
Well, I just know from having raised kids, you know, you spend your life at the baseball field and you're.
Some field.
Yeah, for the tennis court. You're never out of there, you know, on the dark. Right. So I just didn't want that one little thing to hinder you guys or, you know
we can structure around that. Okay.
Matt, and just while they're standing here, and you mentioned being a good neighbor, so if it's anyone from the neighborhood to the east reached to you about concerns of that or anything?
No one from the neighborhood has. There, however, that doesn't always indicate that no one is here this evening.
Wait till it gets lit, right?
correct. Now, one thing I will make as an aside comment, if you compare the master plans, if you count lots to the north, in the 2014 version, the athletic fields are a little bit closer to the neighborhood in terms of the east-west axis than they are with this one. Because of the school expansion, the athletic fields are pushed to the west, which is further away from the houses on the east.
It backs up to what at least south of it.
And I really was questioning if there was even a need, but there is one or two houses at the end of Lips and Dove that would be adjacent to these fields. But they were the only ones.
Commissioners, any questions?
I'm going to ask the question I asked Matt to him. On item number 3, on number 3 where it says the 3 years must be completed within 3 years, do you see a problem with that?
I would prefer if it said started by that date, okay. Just because there's a chance that we may do these academic buildings and have to do fundraising for the gym.
Right.
Well, not on that, I mean, right now, if you're saying the earliest possible time you get to Brooklyn State may be April 1, I mean, we kill 5 months of you right there. So.
Right, and then you got to go have it bid out and go through that process, too. And I'm assuming it's going to take, you know, a year to actually build it out.
I'm sure.
And just make it 5 years.
Yeah.
Okay, so when we have a motion, Commissioner, what do you make a motion to put 5 years? Extend that out. Any other questions? Thank you both for coming forward.
Thank you so much.
Anyone else wishing to speak in favor of this request to come forward this time? Anyone else wishing to speak in favor? There being none, anyone here wishing to speak against this request this evening? Anyone wishing to speak against this request? There being none. Commissioners, we have a presentation from the city on this request this evening, and we've heard all the comments, so this time I'll take a motion on this request.
Mr. Chairman.
Commissioner Wood.
I make a motion to recommend approval to the City of Alabasta with the 3 conditions, with a modification on the 3rd condition being 5 years instead of 3 years.
Okay, so we have a motion from Commissioner Willis to include all the noted conditions with one change on condition number 3. Do I have a second? Got a second, Commissioner Wild. Before we ask for a vote, any discussion on the motion this evening? There being none, at this time I will take a vote. All in favor of this request, please signify by raising your right hand. Ms. Carmella, that is unanimous. Thank you very much, Captain Gallagher.